Good morning and welcome to Your Life A to Z. I'm your host, Lisa Hafner. We have so much to share with you today, so we're going to get started with Suzanne Bissett is here this morning, along with Dr. Theresa Ramsey from the Center for Natural Healing. And we were talking, obviously, it's October, we were talking, it is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, yes. But you really wanted to focus on breast health.
Right. If we focus more on breast health, we realize that we can be so empowered to protect rather than having to come up with new treatment options. And I think if we're more preventive, we'll have less statistics, which
oh,
is
sure.
what the goal is.
Sure.
And you're saying there's some easy things that we can do to be
That's
preventive.
Right.
It's not...
Yeah, we have 5 easy steps that we'll go through today.
Perfect. Easy steps that anyone can do. Thanks, Dr. Ramsey. We'll talk with more on that in just a little bit. Awesome. Now we're talking with Dr. Theresa Ramsey from the Center for Natural Healing again about breast health. 5 easy steps, you say, to make sure that we're as healthy as we can be.
That's right. That's right. And the first step is understanding the breast tissue. So understanding why there's such a high incidence rate of breast cancer in our culture. 1 in 8 females are
wow.
at risk for breast cancer.
Is that high?
And so the structure of the breast is it's all lymphatic tissue. And lymph tissue needs to be moved. And so you can see on the picture how that all of those lines, all that is lymph, and lymph drains into the nodes. So lymph basically carries waste out of the body.
Huh.
And we have lymph that parallels our arms and our legs. We move and we pump it, but our breasts just stay still. And so if we use something to massage our breasts once a day, like I brought poke oil, which is phytolacca, it's a lymphagogue,
poke
which means
oil?
Yeah, poke oil. It's a Native American herb, and what it does is it moves and disperses the lymph, so that if you massage your breast once a day, just for a few minutes, 2 things are happening. You're moving any potential stagnation. Stagnation means stuck, means tumor, right? So you're moving the stagnation, and also you're getting to know what your breasts feel like, so if something changes, you're going to know right away.
And is it like a tablespoon of it, or just a little bit in your hands?
Little bit,
how much
like
do you need?
A teaspoon for
okay.
both breasts, yeah. And it's not to be taken orally, but it's a beautiful, you can use castor oil, you can use anything.
I was going to say, does it matter the
no,
oil?
You can use
okay.
anything. But okay. something to massage your breasts every day, mindfully, to flush the waste.
Okay.
What That's else do we need is hydration. I don't know if you remember, Lisa,
oh, yeah.
how much water do we need every day?
Well, I say it's take your body weight
right.
and divide it in half. And that's how many
ounces
you
right.
should have.
If you're active, double that, right? So
right.
that's for inactive people. So half our body weight in ounces of water per day, minimum.
I can guarantee most of us are not drinking. I mean, there was
not
a time I was very conscious to make sure I was drinking that much, and I've kind of faltered a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And you can tell differences in so many ways, your skin, everything.
It's a push. I feel like I put it out, and every single day, it's a push. It's
yes.
a push.
It doesn't
yeah.
count with coffee.
Go to the water.
Well, no.
Just water. Okay. No, but it's a good try.
Yeah.
But it's funny how we really don't drink enough of it. And from everyone you talk to in the health profession, they will tell you water, water, water.
Right, that's what our lymph system needs. That's what our breast system needs.
To move,
right,
keep
to
the
flush.
Lymph. Where else are lymph nodes or lymph pipes?
Lymph is parallel everywhere. So
okay.
it's kind of taking waste from every cell and dumping it into our colon so we eliminate it.
Okay.
But our breast just don't move, you know.
Right.
And so there's 2 foods that really help breast health. And most women know about this. One is broccoli seed sprouts or broccoli.
Broccoli, though, not alfalfa or...
Right, broccoli.
Broccoli.
Well, wait, does it matter if it's the sprouts or just real regular broccoli?
It can be either, but you're going to need to eat a lot more broccoli than you would the sprouts, because these are much more enzymatically rich of sulforaphane, which in one capsule of Detox 2 or DIM or IC3, these are products you can purchase over the counter. 1 capsule equals 5 cups. One capsule a day or 5 cups a day.
Oh, I don't think I've ever seen these before.
No, I've heard about them, but it's broccoli you have to look for on the label as well.
That's right.
I might be doing the pill.
Yeah,
right.
Well,
I mean, a lot easier.
Yeah, you can juice this, and Johns Hopkins did a test on that. Women who were going in for breast reductions, not cancer, but and they had them drink this right before surgery, and they saw how much uptake went to the breast, and that's how the dosage was determined to protect.
Okay.
You know. And almonds have
Yay.
High, yes.
I love almonds.
High vitamin E, high manganese, they're high in antioxidants, and 4 almonds a day is enough to create really good
really?
Breast health.
Really? Oh, yeah. That's not a lot.
That's right. It's not a lot. It's
no.
not a lot. So we have to eat more broccoli than almonds, but it's true. Or we can take this supplement as well.
Okay. And that's pretty, these things are really good to keep in mind too if you have a history of breast cancer, you know, or any issues, it's good to make sure you're paying attention.
Yes, and just because we have an increased risk, perhaps due to family history, doesn't mean that we're going to get it. I mean,
right.
that's a big deal to me, is the psychology of it all, is just because we have family history, we are going to make ourselves less vulnerable to that outcome, and it's very possible to do. And we talked about that earlier. I have a family history of it. You have a family history.
I have a family history.
I used to believe that was going to be me, but now with all the knowledge, we don't have to even think that. And it's important that we don't, because our mind creates our reality in our body.
That's, yeah, I can see that too. All right, thanks for correcting me on that one.
All right,
what else do we have? No, but it's good to know, yes. And then what else?
So as women age, like breast cancer is usually seen later in life. So let's say 35 and over. And it's not seen when we're younger. There's one hormone that drops that protects our breasts 100%, and it's progesterone. It comes in many forms. And if we start that early enough, that to me is purchasing insurance for breast health in females.
Oh. Yeah, because you do know women who are seem like they're younger getting it, but that's when it can drop off, as early as 35.
That's right. Yeah, hormones are changing a lot earlier now.
And you were saying you can never have a high enough level of that in your body.
You can't have too much. The only side effect really with progesterone is it can make you sleepy. That's one reason women take it at night as a natural sleeping aid. So women can become very sleepy from it, but that's really the only side effect. There's no risks. It's a side effect.
Can you take it in a over-the-counter pill, or do you have to be
Get a cream over-the-counter. The highest dose you'll get is 40 milligrams per gram. That's Dr. Lee's. He's popularized progesterone. And that's a very low dose. That's a dose a teenager would use, you know, for a PMS, you know.
Okay. So what do we need to be taking?
So you would want to get a prescription from your doctor through a compounding pharmacy for bioidentical progesterone.
All right, and what's the last one, Dr. Ramsey?
So iodine is something that we need for optimal breast health. Any kind of cancer, iodine can help against. And I put bromide there. It's in a liquid there because when bromide came into our bread system in the 1940s, breast cancer rates went up from 1 in 20 to 1 in 8. So it really, because it pulled the iodine out. So iodine has been researched in cancer, and so just taking a low dose iodine every day, if you're not allergic to it. But people can't be allergic to iodine because it's a very natural mineral in our body. People think they are because the halogens, like bromide being one of them, fluorine being another one, can displace chlorine being another, and the iodine, and it makes you think you're allergic to it because the cells have all the other halogens. And then you take iodine fish or something and you feel allergic, it's because you have so many of the other halogens toxic in your body.
Wow. So do you put that in your water?
So you have to be tested for it. I don't have anybody, so you might be muscle tested or energetically tested to see what dosage you need.
Oh, okay. So don't mess with that unless you go see a professional.
That's right. But iodine you can buy over the counter. And then vitamin D, you know, those are the things that, iodine and vitamin D would be the supplements that I would suggest because D helps progesterone move into the breast and D helps every cell get rid of waste more efficiently.
Very good. Good things to know. Thank you, Dr. Ramsey. Good tips there.
So
we'll be back a little bit later on. We're going to talk more about this topic, timely this time of month, obviously. Yeah. So thank you again.
There. And I know that you're with Dr. Ramsey, and she has a lot more information for us.
Yes, Dr. Theresa Ramsey from the Center for Natural Healing. You know, she was just talking about moving the lymphatics. We've talked about that earlier, how important that is to do.
Right.
But you were saying not only can you do all of this and stay on top of it, but a lot of it's how you feel and how you, like we were talking about, if you have a genetic history of it, don't buy into the, I'm going to get it.
That's right. And the other thing along the same lines is, if you're going to take detox too, for example, you don't take it and say, oh, I'm going to take this and prevent my cancer. You're going to say, I'm going to take this because I have confidence in my body's well-being. You know, so it's
how, you look
it's how
it.
We take things as well. And if you think about the chest cavity, which has our lungs and our breasts and our heart, our heart is very vulnerable to fear. And so the whole chest cavity then is going to have a vibration that's going to be more vulnerable to any kind of disorder. It could be breast cancer, it could be heart health, it could be lung health. So there's this word we use, ease, which means everything is working fine, and dis-ease, dis is the opposite of ease.
Sure.
And so the more ease we bring into everything we do, mindful eating, mindful drinking, mindful breast massage, then we have this confidence build up inside of us that we don't even think about. Breast cancer. We can go in, get our mammograms with total confidence, not fear. And that's the biggest thing is, are we entering anything from fear or from the perspective of ease? And if we enter it from ease, we're going to have better outcomes overall.
Yeah, I think that could be said for just about anything that you have predisposed to genetically, how you view it and how you're going to deal with it. And
How
you not to be in worry or fear over it.
And that's why if it was up to me, and I could call this month Breast Health Awareness, it's such a different feeling than when you say breast cancer awareness. Mm-hmm. You know, it just takes out that heaviness and brings more lightness. And then there's more momentum towards prevention and cure. But prevention is really where I focus on.
And,
and the statistics, when women actually do this and they have a life that's happy and full, our risks in our clinic are really, really low with breast cancer.
But unfortunately, as you said earlier, 1 out of 8 women starting as young as, what did you say, like 35?
Yeah, 35.
I mean, we're seeing more and more of this. And people who are doing what you're saying, and unfortunately, sometimes it's still just, it happens. But these things that you mentioned can really be beneficial in doing your best to prevent, as you said.
Prevent. Yeah, and if there's any trauma, you know, release that trauma from yourselves.
Very
important. It's a big deal.
Thank you, Dr. Ramsey. Good
You're
tips
welcome.
There. So if you want more information on Dr. Ramsey, you can